receiving, and storage. Follow recommendations from Health Canada and your Ministry of Health on how to store the Pfizer-BioNTech COVID-19 vaccine. The vaccine can be refrigerated up to 30 days after thawing. You must dilute the vaccine within 2 hours after removal from refrigeration. You will need to administer the vaccine within 6 hours after dilution. Supplies and workstation setup. Check your list of supplies. You will need a sharps container, alcohol wipes, gloves, hand sanitizer, and sodium chloride 0.9% preservative-free vials. You'll also need 1 mL and 3 mL syringes and 21 to 25 gauge 1-inch to 1 1/4-inch needles. Include a small bin for garbage, empty bins, and a surface cleaner that contains disinfectant and general varicide. Extra supplies can include a task light, chemo mat, and a gown. Now, find an area away from traffic to designate as your workstation, ideally with a table or desk that can be sanitized. Wipe down the surface of the workstation with your disinfectant or varicide cleaner. If you have a chemo preparation mat, place it on the surface. Arrange supplies on the borders of your work surface in an organized fashion and within easy reach. Place sharps container on the work surface or floor beside you. Choosing and preparing syringes. A variety of needles and syringes are appropriate for diluting and preparing the vaccine. We have found the following products work well. To dilute the vaccine, use a 3 mL syringe and a 21 to 25 gauge needle to draw up 1.8 mL of normal saline. To draw up the vaccine, we recommend a low, dead volume 1 mL syringe and a 23 to 25 gauge needle with a length of 1 inch to 1 1/4 inches. A 1 mL syringe will help you maximize the number of doses from each vial. Here is a tip from our experience. To prepare the 1 mL syringe, hold it with the numbers facing you. Screw on the needle with the safety lock pointing up. This will ensure the gradation numbers on the syringe are not blocked by the needle safety cap when you pull down. Prepare 1 3 mL syringe and 6 1 mL syringes for each vial of vaccine. We recommend wearing gloves when you prepare the needles, dilute the vaccine, and prepare the individual doses. Preparing the normal saline. To prepare the normal saline, use the prepared 3 mL syringe. Swab the top of the normal saline with a clean alcohol swab. Let it dry. You can place the alcohol swab in the work area with the cap of the needle on it to keep it clean. To minimize the number of bubbles in the saline, draw up 2 mL of air in the syringe. Inject the air into the saline vial. Here is a tip to minimize the number of air bubbles. With the saline vial still sitting flat on your work area, release the needle's plunger and allow it to come back out. Invert the saline vial on its side and allow the saline to slowly drip into the syringe. Rotate the syringe to coat the stopper on the plunger while the saline drips in. If the stopper has a bubble on it, slowly push the saline all the way back into the vial. Hold the plunger for a second and then slowly let the saline come back into the syringe. Repeat this step until all bubbles are gone. Once the stopper is coated, you can draw up 1.8 mL required for dilution. Note that a few champagne-sized bubbles are okay. Ensure the bubbles do not affect the final volume of normal saline diluent. Diluting and mixing the vaccine. Take the vaccine out of refrigeration. you can dilute it once it comes to room temperature. Invert the vaccine vial gently 10 times. Remove the cap and swab the top of the vaccine vial with a new alcohol swab. Slowly inject the 1.8 ml of normal saline diluent into the vaccine, allowing the plunger on the needle to come back and equalize the pressure in the vaccine vial. You may need to allow the pressure to equalize more than once while injecting the saline into the vaccine vial to avoid overpressurization and vaccine loss, but do not vent the vial. Once all the saline is injected and before you remove the needle from the vial, pull out about 2 mL of air to equalize the pressure in the vaccine vial. Once again, gently invert the diluted vaccine vial 10 times. Drawing up the doses. The vaccine is now ready to be drawn for administration. We recommend you withdraw all 6 doses at one time. Swab the vaccine vial with a new alcohol swab. Place the swab on your workstation. Draw up 0.25 ml of air into a 1 ml syringe. Remove the needle cap and place it on the alcohol swab to keep it clean. Inject the air into the vaccine vial and slowly draw up 0.3 ml of vaccine. Turn the vial so you can see in between the edges of the label to where the needle is in the vial. This will help prevent drawing air into the syringe. Note, you never want the hub of your syringe to touch the top of the vial. Draw up the vaccine slowly to help prevent bubbles in the syringe. If there are bubbles, inject the vaccine slowly back into the vial and pull up the dose again. Again, a few small champagne bubbles are okay. Never tap or flick the syringe when there is a vaccine in it, as this could inactivate the vaccine. Note that if a syringe prepared with vaccine is dropped, it should be discarded and not administered. You have the correct dose when the top of the plunger stopper is lined up with the 0.3 ml line on the syringe. Remember, when you are drawing up vaccine doses, you want to make a new puncture hole each time. A good tip is to start at the same spot each time. For example, the spot that is right above the lot number and expiry date on the label. Then, rotate the vial either clockwise or counterclockwise for each new vaccine draw. Now you can prepare the next dose. With a new alcohol pad, swab the vial, inject 0.25 ml of air, and draw out 0.3 ml of vaccine. Repeat these steps for a total of 6 doses. Use a new alcohol pad every time a dose is drawn. Note, there is no recommendation to replace the needle on the 1 ml prepared syringes before administration. Using multiple vials to get an extra dose. If you are preparing multiple vials at one time, you can mix the contents of up to 3 vials to get an additional dose. This is one recommended method for pooling the residual vaccine to achieve extra doses. After you drop the 6 doses from the first vial, take a new needle and syringe and draw up the remaining vaccine from this vial. Set this vial and syringe aside. Once you have drawn up the 6 doses from the second vial, you can use the syringe and needle that you set aside from the first vial to draw up the remaining vaccine from the second vial. You can repeat this step with one more vial if needed to get a final dose of 0.3 ml. Once you have a 0.3 ml dose from pulling 2 to 3 vials, change the needle as it might have dulled from entering vaccine vial several times. To change the needle, pull back on the plunger so there is air in the top of the syringe. Unscrew the needle and add a new needle. use one of the vaccine vials you have. Swab it with an alcohol pad, insert the needle, and gently push the plunger up to the 0.3 ml dose with no air or bubbles. If you accidentally push too far, just draw out more of the vaccine from the vial to make the proper dose. If you use three vials and you cannot remove enough vaccine to get an additional dose, discard the vials, needle, and syringe with the partial dose. Your doses are now ready for administration. Label and document as you would in regular practice.